So you've seen portal-less iron farms working in the overworld and end, but have you seen one in the nether? Hello everyone, my name's Emdy and welcome to another farm video. Surprising, I know. This will be a video on a very simple but surprisingly never before seen iron farm that works in all three dimensions and doesn't use portals, but is still 98% maximum efficiency, making a bit over 400 iron per hour with just one of these. If you want to build it, you can skip to the time on screen here, but I would recommend watching this explanation segment so you won't have any issues running it. I'd like to give some credit to Snowy over on ENXO4's Discord for both requesting the farm and giving me an idea for the design. They had asked for a portal-less iron farm to be built in the nether, and when I looked into existing designs, I was surprised to find almost none, and the one I found was a bit inefficient. So I offered to design one for that requirement, and the outcome was quite good. The total designing and testing time for this farm was less than an hour, which shows how simple it is. There are some benefits and a downside to this farm. The upsides are it can be built in any of Minecraft's three dimensions, including the nether, because it uses no water. It's quite efficient, making 406 iron per hour, with the theoretical maximum for a single pod in 1.19 being 411. It's easy to build, taking no more than 10 minutes, excluding transporting the entities. It is the only efficient iron farm out there that works in the nether. The only other nether iron farms I could find is a couple of designs by Mind the Fab, and those don't even make more than 180 iron per hour. There's only one real downside. The sleeping system isn't perfect, and you may have to manually intervene once in a while. More info later. Three villagers standing on beds have line of sight to a zombie in a boat. If they have slept within the past 20 minutes, this is enough for them to spawn a golem on the platform above. The golem that then spawns can also see the zombie, and so it tries to walk towards it and attack, making it fall down this hole and out of range of the villagers, so their golem cooldown is not reset. When the golem is falling past the zombie, it triggers a tripwire that closes a trapdoor, blocking line of sight of the zombie, letting the villagers sleep when it is night. The golem then falls into a lava blade or on a campfire, and the drops are collected by hoppers. The reason why this farm is so efficient is because the golem that spawns on the platform pathfinds off and falls out of checking range of the villagers before they can scan for it again. A golem walks faster than water would push it, so the platform can be pretty big with no issues. There's not much more to it, so with that out of the way, let's get building. To build this farm, you'll need the following materials, as well as three villagers and a zombie. The glass can be any non-spawnable block such as leaves, which are much easier to get. The only time you would need glass is if you put a lava source to kill the golems, but a campfire of either type is easier and safer to get. Any solid block, trapdoor, slab, and boat variant can be used. The temporary block I'm using is moss, but you can use whatever you like. To start, place a double chest with 9 hoppers pointing into it. On the chest, pillar up 3 blocks and make a ring, with the hoppers in the middle. Add a campfire on the middle hopper. On 2 opposite sides, pillar up 3 glass again. Place 2 temporary blocks, 1 glass, and repeat this 4 times more on both sides. When looking down, you should see 5 pairs of temporary block spaces. On the side above the chest, bridge 3 glass out and 1 up, then 2 more in the same direction. Turn inwards and place 4 glass to the side, then turn again and add 3 more. Take 3 trapdoors and place them on the bottom side, filling in the gap. Be careful with this next part if you're in the nether or end. Place 3 beds against this glass block, making sure to hold your crouch button. Back to the pillar, go up 1 and place a solid block on the side away from the beds. Place a solid block on the pillar and dust next to it, with a wooden button away from the middle. Make an L of glass to the side opposite the beds. Place a trapdoor in the end, as well as one facing towards the beds, and one on the side of the block, then open it. Place a solid block and slab above, next to the trapdoor. Continue the left-hand side pillow with glass and a solid block, and set up the tripwire at the solid block level, with string in the middle. Put glass on the solid block and a temporary block on the bedside. Make a 7x3 platform such that it extends a block beyond the pillows on both sides. Then add 5 and 3 block strips like so. On the side at the middle of the platform, place a trapdoor and open it. Place a temporary block against the slab, then place another trapdoor. A temporary block above that and another open trapdoor. Finally, place 2 temporary blocks on the pillows and a glass on each one. Then remove the temporary blocks. Now to move the mobs in. Start with the villagers, getting them to the area and dimension you need, either by lowering them with a workstation, using a boat, or a minecart line. When in the area, get them close to the farm, making sure there are no other unclaimed beds around. Build a staircase up to the beds through the trapdoor. At night, free the villagers and let them sleep in the beds. Then close the trapdoor. Now for the zombie. Staircase using non-spawnable blocks like leaves to the opposite side and place a boat looking at the middle of the trapdoor. Let the zombie chase you up the staircase and walk around the boat so that it gets trapped. Clean up the temporary blocks and then press the button to start the farm. Now a small note. The farm should run without issues for a long time, but very rarely you may notice it stopping, possibly after reloading it. All you have to do in this situation is press the button at night to let them sleep, and it'll start working again just fine. The farm can be chunk loaded or loaded by a player depending on your needs. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you like the farm and it serves you well. Leave a like and comment if you did. Please share this video and check out my other ones, including this redstone series I'm working on. That's all for this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!